Welcome. Well, here we'll take a look how to do debugging in Flutter. We'll debug API from Flutter front end, as well as we'll also combine backend technology, simple backend technology to debug the API. Now, debugging API, I know it's a very painful thing because a lot of the time you have to debug either on Postman or with the framework itself. But previously, I have covered how to debug some of the items or things in Postman, but this time we'll see how to do it using Android Studio itself and the backend. Because a lot of time Postman is not that convenient. For example, in my today's example, what I'm going to show you. Because here I'm going to place an order, but my order is not being placed successfully. So I need to debug it. But the problem is because I'm going to place order, so it is protected by middleware. Now that means that it has a token. Now dealing with the token in Postman, it could be a bit annoying because a lot of time the tokens are auto-generated, so Postman doesn't have direct access. You can access them, but it is painful. So I found doing the debugging from Flutter front end is much easier and it saves time. Okay, so that's what we'll see. Okay, so now here, let me show you what I'm going to do. So here I've already logged in, as you can see. So I've logged in, and over here I'm trying to place an order. So I have added seven items of this order. Now I'll go to my cart over here. Now I'll try to place the order. Now this debugging technique is true for any kind of app if you have your API, because we'll focus on mostly API debugging, but of course we need to use front end as well. Okay, it doesn't matter what kind of app you're using or developing, what kind of backend you are doing, the principle is same. Okay, so through this video we'll learn that. Okay, so now here, let's click on this checkout button. Okay, all right. So if we click on this checkout button, it'll place an order to the server, okay? All right. So but we get an error, it says forbidden. Okay, now if we see some of the logs, but these are warning, don't worry about that. These warnings came at the top, okay? Now let's try to do it one more time. So you do that. Now it started to print from here all the way down there. So in this section over here, we see, well, we have token and our order related information, but for your case it could be any kind of information. Okay, all right, so we get this error. Let's see the error. Here it says forbidden. Now forbidden on the server side, it doesn't matter you're using Java, PHP or C sharp, the idea is same. Forbidden means 403 error. Okay, 403. 403 means forbidden. It means you're trying to do certain action in the database and server is not allowing you to do that. So that's the idea. Okay, so we are looking at 403 error right now. So remember, once you have 403 error, that means that you're trying to do something, but the server is not allowing you to do that. Most probably, maybe it's a token problem or something you're doing that you should not. Okay, so things like that. But we are not sure which one, either it's token or it's other kind of operation related to database, because database is well protected. If you want to mess up with database or database ID, a lot of time you get forbidden error. Okay, so we get 403 over here. So but of course we need to confirm that it is 403. Okay, now here I'm at Flutter front end. Okay, so let me tell you what's happening here. So here I have this checkout button. As you can see, I have this checkout, so which is this one. Now once I call this button, like it's wrapped around gesture detector. Now here we have an onTap event, right? Okay, so once I click on this button, this section get triggered. Okay, so we do a bit of conditional check. We see that whether we logged in or not, but we already did, as I show you. Okay, and if we did that, actually, after that we check if we have address or not. Okay, if you don't have address, we say, okay, let's get me the address. So if things are okay, then we come here and we place the order. Okay, now of course for placing order we create an object and then we call our endpoint, which is called place order, and we pass the order object. Okay, now let's go ahead and check it. What is this? I will click on this. Now here we see that we have this method placeOrder, and it calls another method, okay? Now here we also see interesting thing, we check status code 200. Now we know that status code 200 means that you are, whatever you wanted to get, you got it and everything is smooth, okay? So 200 means perfect, fine, okay. All right, everything went smoothly. So, but for sure we know that we don't get 200, okay? We get 403, but we need to confirm it, right? So here we'll print it, okay? So here I will type in print my status code is, okay? So here I would do response dot status code dot to string, okay? Status code dot to string, okay, right. So I wanna confirm that it is 403, okay? All right, so yeah. So once again, what's happening here? So this method get called and it calls this one, right? And this is the post method, okay? Now it tries to post in the backend, but it was not successful. But whatever it is, the response was given back to this one. Then we return the response from this method to this one over here, right? Okay, they're all well connected. And then we print it, right? But of course we didn't get 200. So whatever we got, we can print it over here because this is a conditional check, right? So always check on the response. If you have error, always check on the response status code. That's the first way to go when you debug Flutter, okay? It doesn't matter you're using what kind of state management system. It could be getX, it could be block, it doesn't matter. So always check with the status code, okay? That's your best friend. So that's where we'll go ahead and try to check it. Okay, let's click on this. Now here we see that my status code is 403. So I told you forbidden means 403. So we know that we get 403, okay, right. So that's confirmed. So now that means we need to look at the backend code. Something is wrong with the backend over here and we don't know what it is, okay? Now we know that this has an endpoint, right? So if we click on this one, okay? So the endpoint is this one, okay, post URI. And if we check it, look at this one here, we see order place. So the point it ends, the end it points actually, that's called place. So the last method that's get called over here, that's the place method. So in our server side, we need to find that one, right? Okay, let's go ahead and find it. Now in my case, this is the order method, okay? Place order, all right? So if you want to know where it is coming from, so this is coming from our API, all right? So here we have, let's see, place order. Okay, right, this one. So place eventually calls place order. So now we have to make sure that this method gets called, okay? All right, so here we could do things like this. So we can try to print to make sure this method actually gets called, okay? So step-by-step debugging. So here we do print R, because I'm in Laravel, so we could do print R, place order, okay? And then we want to die, okay? So we don't want to continue. We're just making sure this method gets called, okay? So I saved it. After that, I'll run my server side, okay? So I saved the code. Now after that, what I'll do, I'll go ahead and hit on this button again, okay? So we'll see this time what gets called. But before that, we could do another thing, okay? Let's see, okay, no, let's go ahead with this one. We see whatever we get, if we can print it over here. Okay, all right, so here is interesting things happening, okay? So it did say that string is not a subtype of int, and it tells me point here. So here, so this time it means that after doing this one, somehow I'm getting 200. And of course this returns, this one over here, returns like a JSON. Now once you return good JSON from the backend, this is more like 200. So yes, we are hitting it, that's how you confirm. Okay, but this method is, just one of the steps that we are going to use, right? Okay, so to be more confirmed that actually whether we are hitting it or not, we could do this thing over here. Actually, we can comment this out. We don't need this thing, all right? And actually, we can comment them all. And over here, just simply print this one, response.body.toString, okay? All right, so now let's hot restart, hot reload. Now click on this one more time. Yeah, so here we see that it says place order, okay? Now, if you look at the code over here, that's what exactly you put. So that means that actually we are able to print this one, okay? So we confirm that we hit our endpoint. So where is the problem now? Now here you see that we do have 1403 over here. That's 1403, okay? All right. Now let's see whether we have other places, 403, okay? Okay, so here we also see another 403. Okay, so what do we understand from this method right now? So either it gets stuck here. Oh, we have another here. So either it gets stuck here, returns from here, or returns from here, or returns from here, okay? Now we can do step-by-step checking, okay? Now this time I'll cut this one and I'll put it over here. And to be confirmed that we can hit right below it, we'll go ahead with the new log. So I'll say place order one, okay? All right, so I'll save it and then run the server. Let me hit it one more time. And here we see one, okay? So that means that this part is all right. It's not blocking me. So I passed this part, okay? So I can cut this one. And next, what I'll do, I'll go ahead and let's see if we can put it. So here, so this is inside a try clause, okay? Try catch clause. So could be that there is a problem here, right? Okay. Now here, actually, I'll try to print one more time and we'll see that if over here things are good or not, okay? All right. Now, I think the best place would be put it, let's see. So right before we return the response, okay, over here. And this time we'll call it place order two, okay? So I'll go ahead and save it. Okay, so let's see if we get place order two or not. Okay, right. So here it says my status code is 403. Now that's coming from here. Interesting. That means that we were not able to hit this point, right? So that means that problems are happening over here. So we can pinpoint the problem. That also means that I don't need to check this 403. I mean, I don't need to come over here. I also don't need to come over here, right? So we pinpointed the problem, okay? So now we need to be more precise, okay? Now, this is one interesting place because we are trying to save information to the database, okay? This is just ordinary variable assignment. Now, saving to the database is a sensitive work. So let's hit over here one. No, let's hit actually right below it. Okay. And we'll see if we can print two or not. If we can print two, that means saving was successful, right? So let's check it. Oops. So it means that we were not able to save it. So that's one problem. So definitely I think this one causing error. Okay. All right, so now here, let me print it here. Let's see if we get three or not. Okay, let me get a little bit organized so that we look good. Okay, let's save it. So now let's hit it. Okay, so here we get three, right? Interesting. So we pinpointed the problem. So we get that this guy is causing the problem. So we are not able to... We are not able to save our information, right? Now we need to take it one step further. So that also means that most probably something is wrong over here with our data. Okay, so that's why database is not allowing you to save. And that's why you get 403 error. So which ends up previously, if you didn't put this one here, it would end up here actually, okay? All right, because die means after that, don't continue. That's all it means, right? So that means that whatever you're trying to save, one of those information has a problem, so database is not allowing you to do that. So that's why you get 403, okay? Now here, we can print stuff like this right now. Print R, and here we do order, okay? Because order is the object that we are trying to save in our database. And after that, we'll die, okay? All right, so I saved it. Now we'll go ahead and run and we'll see what we print over here. Okay, so this time we are able to print things like an array, because our object over here, this has information, order object has information like array, okay? Right, so here, what do we see that, so this is the one that I want to look. First, the order ID, user ID, order amount, and a lot of things, but here it got skipped, okay? So something has to do with the order ID 21, okay? Most probably this could be a problem, okay? So because saving an ID or creating a new ID is very sensitive in database, okay? So yes, but we know that something has to do with this order ID because this order ID is not getting saved with the order information, okay? So that's what we know right now. So let's go. Now this is the time to see what's happening in the database, okay? And what is this order ID? Now this depends on your actual code, how your code is written. But we know that order ID has been generated over here because we place an order and we create an order ID on our own. So we whatever the orders previously we had, we count them and we add one with that, okay? So, and it starts from 10,000. So it means that based on this information over here, it means that previously we had 20 orders and we added one, so it becomes 21. So that became 10,021, right? So I think that's 100,000 actually, sorry, not 10,000, 100,000. So anyway, so whatever was there earlier in the database, you take them all and add it with 100,000 and add one more because this is a new order. So that's why you add one more and then you create an ID. So that's what we see, okay? So that means that it created the order ID but couldn't save it. So something is wrong with this order and order ID itself. So now this is the time you go back and check your database. So why it couldn't save? So because right now we know that the problem happened during saving in the database, right? Okay, so now let's go ahead and check our database. Here is our order and order ID. So these are actually the order ID. Now here we see that order ID is this one. Okay, so this is the order ID 100021. But that's weird, right? Because this is supposed to be a new order ID, but I already have a lot of order ID. So what is this? Where is this coming from? So that's the problem. So yeah, so there is already a new order ID. There is already an order ID that's 21. I mean, 100,021, right? And you created a new one that's also 100,021. So that's why it was not able to save it, okay? So we know that this is the problem because there is already an ID with the same ID in the database. So you can't generate a new one. So that was causing the problem. So in my case, because I'm doing it on a test server, so what I could do, I could go ahead and delete all, okay? So I would check all and delete. Okay, because this is a test server. I don't care about the data, okay? So now my order list over here is empty, no orders, okay? All right. So what I'll do, I'll go ahead and check my backend code. So over here, I'll remove this, okay? Now I'll save the code. Now we'll run our code. Okay, here we also see order ID placed successfully, right? And we generated a new ID. If we check the database. So yes, so there was ID problem, okay? So yes, that's how you debug your Flutter app and you debug your API, okay? So combining Flutter itself and API logging together, you can create a powerful method. So this is the principle, but it depends on what kind of code, where you are, what your method does, okay? So the pinpointing, step-by-step pinpointing, what we did, that's how it works. But of course, pinpointing starts from your front end first, okay? So anytime you have problem with your API, always check the status code, okay? Anyway, thank you so much.